pegged to gold using distributed ledger technology and gold, showing the veracity and the immutability on the ledger and backing it.
And to have the right allocation in your, if you're an asset allocator, an institutional asset allocator, you want to have basically an allocation to a space that matters.
Start all over. And that starting all over comes with trust, and trust and immutability would be things like commodities and blockchains.
First of all, in order
that could
for
be
them-
a digital version of that as well. A digital.
Absolutely. But it has to be easily convertible.
Whether it is Tether, USDC, or many other stable coins, they are now becoming one of those large holders of treasuries. And so from the U.S. government standpoint,
the industrial revolution of the hydrogen production as the new energy. And within that, the idea of the digital currency.
2025 then.
You can change it. The accounting regulation, I think we're absolutely on our way with the passage of this bill in the House, and potentially we get there this year with the passage
for you
of the bill.
2025.
Listen, we got a chance to retire Senator Warren. Trust me, there's a reason she keeps talking about me. Let's keep her scared. John Dean for Senate.com.
Know what you hold?
Enjoy the ride, pal.
It's the XMP.
Welcome back to some more Moon O'Clock News. Shout out to the latest up. Appreciate you stopping by, tuning in. Everything's lining up for a massive pump leading into 2025. They're lying to the masses about XRP. These assets we've been accumulating is where the wealth is being transferred to. We got the total global cryptocurrency market cap today at $2.49 trillion, down about 0.3% in the past 24. We got XRP currently right around 49.50 cents, two for a dollar. Stellar XLM right around 9.5 cents. We got BTC 64,989. We got ETH right around 3,500. We got Flare Networks right around 2.5 cents. XDC 0.033. We got Axelar down into the 60s. Songbird 009. Stronghold 005. Zahal right around 0.09. Evernote right around 17 cents. We got Subject Views to pop things off. Zoe Cruz, one of the founders of the foreign exchange at Morgan Stanley and former Ripple board member.
Reason for an institution to get involved in digital assets today.
I would put it in the context of actually diversification of a portfolio, and to have the right allocation in your, if you're an asset allocator, an institutional asset allocator, you want to have basically an allocation to a space that matters. And we're all in heated agreement. It's not just AI. It is actually the digital asset revolution is very real. And so you want to have an allocation to a space that's going to have huge upside, but also it will inform you. And so for me, a diversifying asset is important, but it will inform you on all the other things in your portfolio that it might affect. And what I mean by that, so educating yourself by having an allocation that's not so big where you get fired if you have a downdraft, but it's big enough you pay attention, is any intermediary, any centralized intermediary is going to be disintermediated at some point down the road. My favorite example is Spotify. Spotify keeps 30 to 40% of the content provider's revenue. Now, you know, unless you are Taylor Swift, you're going to go there and be happy with a 30 to 40%. There's a token, there's an application right now, a project that says to artists, and again, that's ecumenical and why I'm excited in this space that it will change the world. The fact that if you're a content provider and I'm a content buyer, we should agree, peer-to-peer agreement on what that exchange is, I'll charge you a percent, not 30 to 40%. It's going to be years before they get Taylor Swift on it. But think about the cumulative geometric progression. The more artists they get, the more artists they get. So if I know how to track that disintermediation process by traditional asset classes, then I know what things in my portfolio I want to be paying attention to.
We got 707 crypto, digital currency pegged to gold using distributed ledger technology will be the end of the fiat-based system.
Kristalina Georgieva, the head of the IMF, come out and say if a CBDC not pegged to something would just be fiat. What is the only other tier one asset? Gold. I think that there's a very high probability that you also see the West or the IMF issue some form of a digital currency also. pegged to gold using distributed ledger technology and gold, showing the veracity and the immutability on the ledger and backing it. So I don't know where they are, but we are moving in that direction. There's no question about it. We keep getting updates from the finance ministers that indeed this is what they are working on, and they want everyone to come back to the meeting here in August in Russia and report their findings. But I think indeed when you see these are the countries that have been massively accumulating it for a long time and repatriating it, that it is on the docket. It is how you inspire confidence, but not until it's time. So what have they been doing in the meantime? Trading in local currencies and buying gold and oil instead of US treasuries. They're not going to tell us exactly when they're going to release it until they release it. But I think any system, whether it be from the West or from the rest of the world that wants to have credibility, has to be something where immutability and veracity come together. That's gold and blockchain technology. It doesn't have to be redeemable, because De Gaulle from France proved that convertible currencies convert. But if you show the immutability on a blockchain, you have it audited by independent auditors, where there is indeed the inspiring of confidence and veracity, you have a shot. And whether it come from the West or the BRICS first, I don't know. But I will tell you in my heart and in my soul, I know that there will never be another fiat, completely fiat-based system trust ever again. You can only pee in the punch bowl so many times before people stop drinking the punch. And I think now you have to just start all over. And that starting all over comes with trust, and trust and immutability would be things like commodities and blockchain. So don't know where it is, but I know they're working on it.
XRP, the immutable distributed ledger. No more middleman. Yeah, Weird Nation unboxed. The next digital currency needs to be more broad and easily convertible. RLUSD, XRP. XRP ledger.
There's already a fund where any country that's holding dollar denominated assets can just deposit them into the IMF, and then the IMF can convert them into SDRs, or and then you can convert the SDRs into yuan or any other currency. So this is it. We are at the end now, whether or not China and Russia is going to be the next world reserve currency, the yuan or the ruble, that is, in my opinion, doubtful. I think it's more going to be the SDR, because it just makes a whole lot more sense to me.
But we've also got the BRICS coming together with their different reserve currency backed by commodity, the collective reserve currency from all of these countries together backed by commodities, including gold, including oil. Do you not think that that is the more likely replacement here?
I really don't, because it's not, I don't think it's broad enough when we get into this digital currency system. I think that they still need one that is more broad. And since you're talking about a basket currency that's backed by commodities. First of all, in order
for
them.
That could be a digital version of that as well. A digital.
Absolutely. But it has to be easily convertible. And I don't know that that would be globally easily convertible, like the SDR would be more easily convertible. And the weighting of those BRICS currencies can be much bigger inside of the SDR.
All right.
But then you'll have the global currency and you'll have the local currency. And that's what the dollar is going to end up being, is just a local currency.
XRP. The bridge asset. We got XRP drops. Stablecoins are now kind of too big to fail from a systemic standpoint.
Coins are probably becoming so large and important that they're now kind of too big to fail from a systemic standpoint, which is hilarious given what the legacy financial system went through with the banks in 2008, 2009. But stablecoins now do collectively as much transaction volume as Visa. They also are the 16th largest holder of U.S. treasuries. That's really important, because at the time when China and Japan, who used to buy 22% of U.S. treasuries, are only buying about 7%, we need somebody else to step in and be those buyers of treasury. And so whether it is Tether, USDC, or many other stablecoins, they are now becoming one of those large holders of treasuries. And so from the U.S. government standpoint, they're really important, and we need to make sure that they continue to buy them and hold those treasuries. At the same time, I think what you're seeing is people realize, hey, I don't want to spend my Bitcoin. I don't want to spend an asset that I think is going to go up in value over time. It serves as this great store of value. So if I do want to buy things using these new crypto rails, maybe it's better to spend the thing that's going to be worth less in the future and kind of spend the fiat money. And so it looks like there's kind of this, you know, symbiotic relationship that is being created where Bitcoin is preserving value and stablecoins are allowing you to transact value, and they're kind of rising together.
We got Mr. Man XRP Bricks. We're on the eve of the industrial revolution of hydrogen production as the new energy, and that carries with it a new digital currency payment system like XRP. Better get them drops in. The liquidity is ready to flow.
We are on the eve of the industrial revolution of the hydrogen production as the new energy. And within that, the idea of the digital currency payment system within BRICS and Eurasian Union, it's very important and up to date.
We got XRP Jobs. Ripple's partnership with Axelar is an absolute game changer. XRPL EVM sidechain. Axelar achieved today an ecosystem milestone. Over 9 billion in value has been transferred and over 2 million transactions have been completed via the Axelar network. 9 billion plus volume, 2 million transactions. Chad Steinberger says it's absolutely 2025 on regulations, stablecoins, and more crypto businesses going IPO, DAI. Regulated stablecoins, Kraken IPO 2025, XRP ETF 2025, Ripple IPO 2025.
The reality is that there's right now, you know, if we talk about stablecoins, the US dollar stablecoin with huge adoption there, over $100 billion of adoption. That's something that actually kind of promotes the usage of the dollar, not just here in the US, but globally. And many of the stable coins also coming into the regulatory fold, regulatory compliant, as is Kraken, following the regulations that are in place for anti-money laundering and so forth. So I really don't think that's the answer, but it is baffling because then you ask the question, well, what could it be? And it's a bit of a mystery.
So the election's coming. Do you think former President Trump is sincere about his recent comments about crypto? Does he understand crypto, Bitcoin? Do you take him at his word that it would be a friendlier touch?
Yeah, everyone goes on a journey with Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. I did myself, and you know, his comments on Bitcoin and cryptocurrency are recent. So I would hope that he's kind of on that learning journey, learning more about it. When individuals actually take the time to learn about Bitcoin and cryptocurrency, it's almost always a positive outcome.
2024 will be the year of more accommodating regulation and an IPO for your company?
So 2025 was your question? I think.
No, 2024.
Oh, this year. Okay. We got to go quicker.
No, 2025. 2025 then.
Accommodating regulation, I think we're absolutely on our way with the passage of this bill in the House, and potentially we get there this year with the passage of the bill.
For you, 2025.
And then as far as Kraken, you know, fundraise, IPO, all of these things are out there. Timing is, you know, not something that we're, you know, defined specifically at this point in time.
Okay.
Best is still yet to come. Crawl, walk, then we rock it. All banks using XRP in Japan. 2025, right around the corner. We got a message from Big John Deaton. Please help before June 30th.
It's John Deaton. Listen, 10 days until the end of the quarter. June 30th is the end of this quarter. I need your help. Please go to johndeatonforsenate.com and donate whatever you can. $20, $100, $500, $1,000. Hopefully you can max out. Listen, we got a chance to retire Senator Warren. Trust me. There's a reason she keeps talking about me. Let's keep her scared. johndeatonforsenate.com. 10 days until the end of the quarter. Help me out.
We got one from Santa Mafee. The crowd is mainly fearful or disinterested towards Bitcoin as prices range between 65 and 66K. This extended level of FUD is rare as traders continue to capitulate. BTC trader fatigue combined with well accumulation generally leads to bounces that reward the patient. We got mustache. These are the massive signs that altcoins will rise exponentially in 2024, running into 2025. The chart looks like it did in 2020 or even 2017. The two-week Gaussian channel has changed from red to green. Don't get shaken out of the market. This is just a retest, in my opinion. The longer they take, the higher we climb on that XRP risk list. We got Dark Defender. XRP BTC pair has a reversal in the weekly time frame to the golden cross where the RSI is confirmed. BTC will lose dominance against XRP starting now. Very short term targets, 5286 to 6649 support, 4623. Edgrad Crypto, XRP quarterly hammer, bullish candle formation. XRP on the 3-month time frame has shown two hammer candles before major pumps, one April to June 2016, the second July to September 2017. Right now, XRP needs to close the next 3-month candle above 55 cents to 58 cents in the next 10 days to form another perfect hammer formation. This will be a powerful bullish signal hinting at a mega pump just around the corner. If we get a hammer, expect a pump of around 1,700%, $8 starting in July of 2024. If we need hammer one, we might just have to wait another 6 months, but the pump will be epic around 5,500%, taking us to $27. Keep a very close eye on this candle formation in the next 10 days. XRP Army, stay ready. Keep on accumulating. And XRP drops. This is absolutely impressive to see that RippleNet plays a significant role in the various BRICS countries. The same applies to BRICS Plus. BRICS Pay countries are expected to be made in wholesale CBDCs. All roads lead to the bridge. XRP, the RippleNet. It's no wonder that the deep state SEC wants you out, wants those XRP bags back. But let our friend know that the greatest opportunity of multiple lifetimes are still at hand, and they're lying to the masses about XRP. And these assets that we've been accumulating is where the wealth is being transferred to, coming to a wallet near you. Where will those bags be when that regulation jar molasses finally breaks open and XRP's true price is finally revealed?
Big bags.
Later, glitches.
Knew it would happen and we told you. We told you. We told you. We knew it would happen and we told you. We told you. We told you, we knew it would happen and we told you. We told you, we told you. We knew it would happen and we told you. We told you, we told you. We knew it would happen and we told you. We told you, we told you. We knew it would happen and we told you. We told you, we told you. I told my boss I put my 2 weeks on feeling bullish. Never coming back.